A.
Another vowel?
E.
A consonant?
S.
A vowel?
A.
And consonant, please.
Lastly, R.
And here's the clock. How have you done?
Seven.
A seven from Joe. And Richard?
Just a seven.
A seven. Let's hear yours.
Waiters?
Same word.
Same, so two waiters. It's just leading us into another food thing, isn't it, Dan?
I've avoided food because I'm just working my way through makes of Ford. Sierra is in there as well. Ford Sierra, building on the Escort. And Susie, if I had more warts than you, could I be wartier?
You definitely could.
Excellent. Okay. What's that? Seven. That's a seven as well, wartier.
Thank you. Anyway, I think it's time, Richard, for your choice of numbers.
Can I have one large, please, Rachel?
You can indeed. Thank you, Richard. One from the top and a flying V. And the five little ones are 2, 6, 4, 5, and 7, and the large one, 25. And your target, 788.
788, and the clock starts now. Richard, the target was 788. How have you done?
790.
Joe?
788.
Let's hear it.
25 times 5 is 125.
Yep.
At 7, 132. 132 times 6 is 792, and then take off the 4.
Very well done. 788.
Bravo. Well, folks, we can give ourselves a rest now as we turn to our Dictionary Corner guest, Dan Walker, who might as well be covered in flaky pastry, the way we're going so far.
It's been lovely to be here this week. I've enjoyed sharing some stories from my book called Standing on the Shoulders, which is all about people who've been through some tough times but somehow get through to the other side. And in the most recent book, I caught up with somebody who I've spoken to before. Her name is Lisa Ashton, and she was working in South Africa many years ago, where she came across an elderly lady there who is feeding hundreds of children, mostly orphans, from one giant bowl of soup. And the name of the woman was Winnie Mabaso. And Lisa was so inspired by that one encounter that she gave up the job that she was doing, and she now works full-time for